How are you? Now we are going to start, and I want to tell you that in the previous video in which we are talking about the certs and indices, at the end of video you have seen our exercise. So I think some of the questions I solve for you and it helps you. So see some questions, the solution of some questions I have shown with the explanation. Yes, see question number 1 of the exercise, that is under root 8 to the power 1/3. We need to solve it. So under root means power 1/2, as you know it is the indices. Then it is power, one power on another one, then they are multiply. So it is 8 means 2 to the power 3, that is 2 to the power 3 to the power 1/6. Then again they are in multiplication, 2 to the power 3/6. It means 2 to the power 1/2, it means it is under root. So the value of under root 8 to the power 1/3 is under root 2. That's it. Next is question number 3 from the exercise. It is given 16 multiply 8 to the power n plus 2 equal to 2 to the power m. And we want to find the value of m in term of n. So 16 means 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 means 2 to the power 4. And 8 is 2 to the power 3. Then another power n plus 2 equal to 2 to the power m. Then 2 to the power 4, since here the powers have another power, then they becomes in multiplication, 3 bracket n plus 2 multiplied 2 to the power 3 n plus 6. But there are two numbers in multiplication, same numbers with different powers in multiplication, so power will be add. So it is 2 to the power 4 plus 3 n plus 6 equal to 2 to the power m. Then it is 2 to the power 3n plus 10 equal to 2 to the power m. And rule is, if the numbers are same, therefore they are certs, or we can say the exponents, or we can say the powers must be same. That therefore 3n plus 10 equal to 2 to 3n plus 10 equal to m. So the value of m in term of n is 3n plus 10. Question number 5 of the exercise. This is given in the exercise. So what can do, since here it is given the under root, so for removing the under root we need to multi squaring both sides. So on squaring both sides, when we square the left side, this under root will remove, and here it is 3 square. Then this 5 send into the left side. 3 square means 9 minus 5, and it is cube root of x equal to 4. Then x equal to, taking the cube root, x equal to 4 cube, x equal to 64. Now question number 8. In this one we want to find the value of x. It is given 2 to the power 2x minus 1 equal to 1 upon 8 to the power x minus 3. Since here it is given 8 to the power x minus 3 in denominator, so when we send it on the numerator, its power change into minus 1. So x to the 8 to the power x minus 3, again the power is minus 1. So these two powers comes in multiplication, minus 1 multiply with x minus 3, then it change minus x plus 3. But we know that 8 means 2 to the power 3. So this 3 multiply with minus x plus 3, and it change into minus 3x plus 9. So the left hand side 2 to the power 2x minus 1 becomes equal to 2 to the power minus 3x plus 9. Since the base is same, so powers must be same, means 2x minus 1 equal to minus 3x plus 9. Change the side, 2x plus 3x equal to 9 plus 1, 5x plus 10, 5x equal to 10, x equal to 2. Same question is here, question number 12.
2 to the power x plus 4 minus 2 to the power x plus 2 equal to 3. So here we separate the powers, 2 to the power x multiply 2 to the power 4. Same here, minus 2 to the power x multiply 2 to the power 2 equal to 3. Now put 2 to the power x equal to y. Then here 2 to the power 4 means 16 and 2 to the power x is y. So this first term change into 16y. And second term similarly change in 4y equal to 3. Then 12y equal to 3. Then y equal to 3 by 12 means 1 by 4. Then 2 to the power x equal to 1 upon 2 to the power 2. When we send this denominator to the numerator, the sign of power will be changed. Then 2 to the power x equal to 2 to the power minus 2. Then x equal to minus 2. Then question number 17. You can see in the exercise, it is given 9 to the power n multiply 3 to the power 5, 27 to the power 3, divide by 3 multiply 81 to the power 4 equal to 27. And we want to find the value of n. So you can see we can change all the numbers in the form of multiple of 3. 9 means 3 square to the power n, 3 to the power 5 is as it is, 27 change into 3 to the power 3, and another power 3 is there. In the denominator 3 comes as it is. 81 means 3 to the power 4, and another power is 4. So by using the law we can write it 3 to the power 2n, 3 to the power 5 as it is, and this comes 3 to the power 9, 3 to the power 1, 3 to the power 16 equal to 3 to the power 3. Then 3 to the power 2n multiply 3 to the power 14 upon 3 to the power 17 equal to 3 to the power 3. Then the powers in multiplication comes in addition, and the power in denominator comes in division. So the left side comes 3 to the power 2n plus 14 minus 17, and right side 3 to the power 3. By solving it comes 3 to the power 2n minus 3 equal to 3 to the power 3. Then powers become same, 2n minus 3 equal to 3, and 2n equal to 6, n equal to 3. Question number 22. In this one you can see it is given A equal to L minus M, B equal to M minus N, C equal to N minus L, and we want to find the value of X to the power A to the power N, multiply X to the power B to the power L, multiply X to the power C to the power M. So for solving it, we should put the value of A, B, C in the question. So at the place of A we can write L minus M, at the place of B we can write M minus N, at the place of C we can write N minus L, and then multiply the power. So it is change X to the power LN minus MN, it is change into X to the power ML minus LN, it change into X to the power MN minus MN. So since these numbers are in multiplication, so we can add the power. After adding the power, this term has come. And you can see the plus minus terms will cancel, and it comes only x to the power 0. And when the power 0 of any number always 1, so it is x to the power 1. One more solution is here. See it yourself and try to understood. If you are unable, then you can ask it.